Okay, now we'll see about standard input output errors, then standard errors, pipelines, and find command. Right? Perfect. Now, coming on to standard input output and standard errors. Standard input is anything which you type inside your console is basically going to be standard input. Okay? And mostly, almost everything which the machine throws out to the standard console is standard output, except when there are errors, then it becomes standard error output. So, standard errors. Okay. So, as an example for standard input, we can say when I try to cat a file and type something into the file with this particular symbol, whatever thing which I type inside my terminal will become my standard input. Okay, so it's something like this cat file dot txt, and say I type in 1 2 3 4 5, return control D. Okay, so all these numbers become my standard input right now. So if I were to cat this particular file in this particular fashion, then my file becomes my input via my standard input. All right, for the cat command. Perfect. Now for the standard output, if I hit ls, so whatever this particular command throws out, it's not getting error, and this is in the standard output. Okay. If I were to type mkdir d, voila. Okay. So it's telling that the command is not found, but this is not standard output, but whereas this is standard error. Okay. And in order to prove that this is not standard output, I'm going to write to a file whatever ls command throws out. Okay, ls command throughout what? Desktop file.txt folder and num. Okay, I'm going to put it as stdout. Okay, dot txt. Okay, if I were to cat stdout.txt, I could find all the things which ls command throws. Okay, and if I were to do the same thing for mkdir bala. Okay, to std out 1.txt. Okay, it did throughout something, but it's not written over there. If I were to cat standard out 1.txt, it's not in there. If I have to write whatever errors which are thrown out to the standard output, okay, into the file as a standard output, okay, this error is actually a standard error message, okay, which is actually you cannot call this a standard output, but this is standard error message. Okay, and we have to move even that one into this particular stuff. I have to put an ampersand symbol here and hit on enter. Now if I cat standard out 1.txt, I can find that particular error inside that particular file. All right, so that is for these three things. Now coming on to pipeline. Okay, pipelines are an important concept. It's a very simple concept. It's nothing but it takes the output of one command and gives it as an input to the second command. All right, so this ls command, okay, is going to give me a bunch of output files, right? Let me clear it off. Ls. Okay, it throws me so many files. Okay, grep command is a pattern matching command. Okay, ls, I'm going to pipe it. This particular symbol you can find it above the enter command, enter key. Okay, grep is a pattern matching command. It's going to match for the letter I in the output shown above. Okay, when I hit on enter, I can see just one thing, because I has appeared only in file, not in desktop, not in folder, not in num, not in standard out 1.txt, or not in standard out .txt. All right, that's for that. Then let me cat this hc passwd file, which contains all our username. Okay, so many files are there. I just want to see the first five lines. How do I do that? Okay, there is a particular command called as head. I can pipe this through head. Okay, and tell it to display only the first five lines by hyphen 5. So it's displaying only the first five lines. Similarly, I can ask it to give only the last five lines. Okay, you get the point, right? Next. Oh, I finished head and tail. Okay, let me complete up this one. Okay, let me clear it out this one. So I'm going to grep on all the places where root occurs. Okay, if I were to add a hyphen C over here, it will tell me number of lines wherein root has occurred. Okay, in this line root has occurred and in this line root has occurred. If I were to put N along with this, okay, it will tell me the lines on which these things matched. Then I'm going to grep INMA. I stands for case insensitive. So if it is capital MA, if I'm going to grep this, if the file has only small MA, it will match that. Probably a mail, something like mail, my name, MANIAM, end of my name will contain MA. It should pull out all those stuff. For mail, MA, even though it's capital M, it doesn't matter because that letter of I is there, which makes it case insensitive. Then port mapper, Balasubramaniam, okay, has MA in it. Alright, perfect. Then more and less command. I can cat, okay, hit up arrow, that's much easier. MORE, and to scroll down I have to hit spacebar. Okay, and if I want more flexibility, I could have typed less command, so I can move up and down. Okay, hit on Q to close it. It's much easier for us to open less command like this, HCE parse WD. So we need not go through cat and pipe it. I have just shown that for your example. Alright. So moving on to the next slide. Coming to sort. Okay. Okay, perfect. So I'm going to cat hc parse wd. You saw all this mail, like all these lines, like they are not in alphabetical order, they are not arranged alphabetically. So I'm going to sort it. It will sort based on the first column. Okay, saw that? I've given sort over here. As you could see, this file size is really large. Okay. ADM Apache. If I want to put it in reverse mode, hit hyphen R, hit on enter. Okay, there you have it. Then I'll come back to the which command little bit later on. Let me show another trick on this. Okay, I am going to head 5 lines. Or let me put a head, it will default give me 10 lines, hc parse wd. Okay, out of this, I want this particular file to be arranged with the fourth column alone. Okay, you think that the fourth column is already arranged, right? 0, 1, 2, 4, 7, 0. Oops, it's not arranged. So let us arrange it likewise. So parse wd, sort, hyphen t. I have to tell what is the limiter on this particular file. This is a colon limited file, so I have to put the colon. Okay, and after first column, then colon, second column, then colon, third column, then colon, fourth column is what I'm going to look at. Hyphen k. Okay, fourth column, arrange it by fourth column. You saw that 0 has come on top. 0 0 0 0 12 13. Oops, that's a bummer, because sort command just looks at the first character and arranges it. It's good if it is alphabets, but it's not good when it's numbers. So what you have to do is you have to ask sort to sort it by number. Okay, by including hyphen n as well. So if you see the fourth, it's 0 0 0 0 1 2 4 7 12 and 13. All right perfect, man. Okay, so we have done that. Now we are going to I have already created a num file wherein I have given all these numbers. Okay, I can sort it directly, sort num, okay? But as you can see, it has not sorted it correctly. 22, because 22 has come before 3, because sort just looks at the first character. For that, I have to include n over there, okay? If I have to do it in the reverse manner, put r over there. Simple as that. Perfect. Now coming to word count, wc num, hit on enter. So this particular stuff will give us the number of lines, number of words, then number of characters, which is bytes in that, okay, ASCII in it actually. So it's telling that it has 12. Let us count it. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, okay. Then there is an enter over here which you cannot see, but it is counting that as a character. So 8 9 10 11 and 12 at last, okay. So that's where you're getting the 12 from. Then okay, cut is a super stuff. Let me show that to you. Clear it out. Head hc pass wd, okay. So I want to cut just the fourth column over here and print out for me, okay. How could I do that, okay? That would be really interesting for me to pull out just that line, because there are certain times wherein you need to import this onto an Excel sheet and you just need one particular column alone on that, okay. So what we are going to do for that is pass it through a command called cut, okay. Hyphen t is the tab limiter, is going to be it's not tab limiter, it's a colon limited file. Hyphen t, then hyphen d is for the column. Hyphen k is for the column. So in k, I'm going to cut out just the fourth column. Hit on enter. D. Then F is what I need to supply over here. Okay. As you can see, it has just pulled out the first. This fourth line alone for me. 12. 13, 12, 0, 0, 0, so 0, 0, 0, then 7, it's there, yeah, 0, 0, 0, 7, 4, 2, 1, 0, you get the point, right? So let's move to the next one, wherein we are going to use this particular command called find. Find just finds the stuff which you want to find in your system, and this find is really cool, it helps us to find lots of things. So let me hit on clear. Alright, so what I'm going to do is, I'm going to, since I am as a user and my passwd is home, on my present working directory is home bala, I'm going to type find in my present working directory called bala hyphen name. I want to find a folder called animal. You remember that? This was done in the first video. Hit on enter. It's not there. Probably I misspelled it. A-N-I-M-A-L. Ooh, strange. Going to the desktop. LS. Oh, that's a cat. It ends with S. Okay. So, I have to add another S to it. Saw that? It's finding it. Perfect. Right? So, that's about finding. And you can also find, it's not just with names which you can find, you can also match it with size, okay. You can give a hyphen, you can give it as just 1k for kilobytes. I have to give small letter k. So all these files are almost 1k in size. Clear it out, okay. So if I have to find files which are less than 1k, put minus 1, okay. You can see all these things, four legs, all these are 0k files, okay. No, nothing is typed inside those things, so it pulls them out for us, okay. So if you were to see this, permissions, if you put perm and find files which are with this permission, it will pull out for you. Let me go upstairs. It's not upstairs actually. Perm 644. there it is, all the files with permission 644. Okay, then if I have to find with kilobytes, I have to put K. If I have to find with bytes, C. M for megabytes, G for gigabytes. Okay, and that completes the standard input output error pipelines and find command. So thanks a lot for viewing this video. Bye bye.